Hi Pisces, welcome back to Omkara Tarot and let's do your love bite now. Let's see what message wants to show through for you today, Pisces. And these are general collective readings, will not resonate with all of you. Please keep that in mind. Take what works for you, leave the rest. So Pisces, let's begin your reading. My angel spirit guides, please bless this reading for Pisces and send them the messages they need to hear the most right now. Thank you. So Pisces, welcome back all my subscribers. Thank you for being here. And if you're new here, Pisces, we welcome you also. Do join us, subscribe to the channel, become part of us. We welcome you in. All right, I have the death card center of my spread here. So either a big transformation coming into your life here, Pisces. Oh, the sun card is here as well with the lovers and the page of wands. That's nice. I have a king of cups in the upright bottom of my deck. Very nice. All right. So from what I see here, Pisces, I have a queen of swords here who's not taking any bullshit now. They don't want to live in regret and sorrow for the rest of their life, and they are cutting off things which don't serve them. They were looking for a king of pentacles who would be their spouse, who would, you know, kind of be there for them for the long haul. And now they're feeling it's becoming too much of a burden. It's time to transform my life now and put my boundaries up. But I do see in the last row somebody coming in with a message. A choice is being made. This is a very strong, powerful connection, I feel. And I end with the sun card. So I don't know what's happening here, Pisces, but it looks good. So let's start with some dialogue message cards between the two of you, and then we'll clarify the reading, okay? And if any of you are looking for a personal reading, Pisces, my email is in the description box below. You can reach me there. So Pisces and their person. Pisces and their person. Okay. And I'm going to take a few from here, Pisces. Pisces and their person spirit. Okay. And a couple from here. Mix it up a bit. All right. Good to go, Pisces. Let's begin your reading. Looks like an interesting one today. I know you feel the same way. If you didn't, why would you keep in touch and get triggered when I say next lifetime? We're getting older and wasting precious time playing these dumbass runner chaser games. Let's just level the F up already. Are we doing this or what? Doesn't that sound like the Queen of Swords here? Who's saying, hey, just either get on, you know, this wheel of fortune or jump off. So, okay. Who knew that one of the greatest challenges of my life would be the love of my life, who after meeting would eternally haunt my very existence? So this Queen of Swords is fed up, I think. Your inconsistent behavior has caused my family to have concerns and trust issues regarding you. This has now created another barrier for us to navigate and overcome. My mind is in turmoil, trying to figure out how I can fix the mess I've made. I'm suffering from sleepless nights and feeling very low and anxious. Every night I just want to be home, and home is in your arms. So somebody's really messed up this connection, and the Queen of Swords is ready now to kind of leave the building here. I'm planning a surprise engagement. I want to ask you to marry me. Will you say yes? See, I told you there's somebody who's suddenly feeling all loved up here, maybe wanting to start a brand new chapter with this Queen of Swords. Okay. We see this from two different perspectives. So either you commit to me or you're out. You can't have your cake and eat it too. I think that's what the Queen of Swords is saying. Let's talk and clear the air. Yeah, somebody wants to now send in a message or talk or, you know, something. So let's now clarify this reading. But before that, I am going to take an angel blessing card. Let's see how my angels are going to bless this reading with a blessing, guidance, advice, or a message for my Pisces gang. Look deeper, Pisces. Just when you think that thing is happening, a lot is happening in the background. Maybe, you know, on the surface you must be saying, but I haven't heard from them. Nobody has yet gotten in touch with me and whatever. But you don't know what's happening on the other side. Just like this little pond, which is so placid, right? But deep inside, there's so much life, so much activity, which this angel can't see. On the surface, it looks really calm and nice and, you know, there's no movement. So sometimes when we manifest things, Pisces, the universe is actually doing a lot of work behind, you know, in the background. So look deeper. All right. So let's start your reading now. Queen of Swords is my first card. So Queen of Swords, what would you like to say here? Queen of Swords. My Queen of Swords says, my person has been very inconsistent, has dipped in and out of my life, is very immature, never steps up to the plate, and behaves like a, you know, college boy or a player. Anything else, ma'am? Queen of Swords here. Would you like to say something else? Queen of Swords. Yes, this Queen of Swords says, I'm the only one who's been feeding this connection. My person just has been taking and taking and taking, and my cup has runneth dry now. I don't have one drop left now to give to this connection. I am drained out because this person is not filling my cup back. It has to be an equal give and take, where I give some and he pours, or, you know, my person pours into my cup. But here I am sitting here with an empty cup because it's all been taken away from me. I can't deal with this anymore. Five of Cups, Spirit in reverse. Five of Cups. Yeah, somebody says, to bring back justice and balance into my life, I have to do something myself. I'm not going to sit here in this regret and sorrow and always looking back and waiting for this person to level up, become that King of Pentacles, which I've always wanted them to be, you know, that perfect partner. I'm not waiting around. I've spent enough time, you know, everything's been drained out into the ground. All my emotions, all my time. And I'm not ready to do that anymore. I'm planning to bring justice back to my life. So, King of Pentacles, Spirit. What's this King of Pentacles? This Queen of Pentacles, I think, has now put an end to this past person. And maybe is now, you know, looking out. This trying to see what else is out there. Maybe if this is not my King of Pentacles, I'll find this person somewhere else outside. Further on, I'm looking into my future now. Maybe there is somebody who's going to bring that justice and balance and pour back into my cup for a change. Ten of Wands. Yes, this Queen of Swords has now picked themselves up. Now they've become the Queen of Wands. They're looking great. People are watching them. Maybe they are, you know, pursuing their passions, their work, concentrating on their pentacles, looking after themselves. This is an active choice, I think, this Queen of Wands is making, because the old baggage became just too heavy for them to carry. I think they are now saying, enough is enough. I'm not going to carry all the burden. All 10 wands are too much for me to bear. If you can't share half my load, then I'm going to work towards something else. First of all, myself, right? So, Death card, Spirit. Death card. They feel their partner was very, very selfish. Very self-centered, very selfish, and never took action to bring stability into this connection. Always kept them maybe in a loop, waiting, and each time maybe was even not just selfish but also very inconsistent, very unemotional, maybe lied to them, their communication skills were not that great. And that's the reason I think the Queen of Swords is saying, I'm going to put an end to this chapter. I'm not going to do one more round, one more cycle with this person. I'm going to keep my boundaries up with the Seven of Wands. And because I'm going off for my fresh new beginning here. Look at this. I've got my boundaries up now. I'm not going to repeat that chapter one more time. I'm leaping off that cliff and freeing myself. Page of Wands, Spirit. What's this Page of Wands? Page of Wands. Page of Wands. One more. Page of Wands. Who is this Page of Wands, Spirit? Who's this Page of Wands? And the Lovers? Oh. And the Sun card? And the Sun card? Oh. And the King of Cups, Spirit? All right. See, this is what happens when you pick yourself up, Pisces, if you are the feminine here. Now, this past person who was emotionally never available, right? They were always hiding their emotions. Sometimes they would be nice, sometimes not so nice. Now, because this Queen of Swords has picked up her sword, here they're feeling all, you know, left out, abandoned, feeling lost. So now they're thinking of coming up, you know, wanting to maybe come and give a message or something after there has been no movement. Everything's totally become stagnant. Now this person is saying, oh my God, why didn't I accept that offer when I had it? Now that offer is no longer available for me. And now this person is going into a bit of sadness and depression. Now they're making that choice to return. Be very mindful, Pisces. This person wants to return now, and that's why that card came out. I'm planning to return with, you know, and for a surprise engagement or something. Will you say yes? Now they've realized that this is the Queen of Swords that I want. This is my happiness. And they feel like a loser. Whatever mind games they've played with this feminine, they feel they lost. Now they are seeing this union as actually the one that can give them the Ten of Cups here, Pisces. They also know that they haven't invested in this connection till now. They're lacking a little bit of courage, if I may say so, because they feel this Queen of Swords person has stopped fighting for this connection and may not be even willing to have a reunion with them. So they're lacking a little bit of courage here. They are, because they know they haven't put in the work. With what face are they going to come back? Maybe it's been a long time or some time has gone by. And there's too much stagnancy that's happened between the two of you. So now this person is kind of lacking courage to face this Queen of Swords because they have invested nothing till now. And now they're feeling that love. They are feeling that love. They are feeling left out and abandoned. They do want to start this brand new chapter. But the whole problem here, Pisces, is when they needed to offer commitment, they never did. They never offered what this feminine was wanting, the Four of Wands. Right? So Pisces, a couple of you did message me to say that, you know, they were coming back with the proposal and, you know, now you're saying. The point here is time is fluid. I can't promise you when it's going to happen. But like my angels are saying, look deeper. You don't know what's going on in the background. When you feel nothing is happening, something could be happening. Right? Now, whether you wish to accept this person back or not, that's also totally your choice. Some of you will, some of you won't. This is a public reading. This is not a private reading, Pisces. All right, so each of you can have different outcomes here. So that's all I have for you for this time. And we will see you soon next time now. Love and light. Take care. Namaste.